Okay. Wow. 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 Morning, y'all. Good afternoon. I just see some breaking news. Well, it ain't just breaking, but my brother Biz Markie. You got what I need, and you say I'm just a friend. Oh man, that's just. So, what they're reporting, the Daily Mail is reporting that Biz Markie, who rapped the classic song Just a Friend, dies at 57. Biz Markie, the rapper who rose to fame with the one-hit wonder Just a Friend, has died at the age of 57. The hip-hop legend died at a Baltimore hospital on Friday from complications from diabetes. Although Markie was best known for his instantly catching song and other tunes, he inadvertently helped to end an era of unchecked sampling in hip-hop as a result of a 1991 lawsuit against him. Jenny Izumi, a representative for the late rapper, reacted to the news of his death in a statement. "It is with profound sadness that we announce this evening with his wife Tara by his side, the pioneer rapper Biz Markie peacefully died. Wow. We are grateful for many calls and prayers and support that we have received during this difficult time. Biz created a legacy of artistry that will forever be celebrated by his peers in the industry and his beloved fans whose lives he was able to touch through music spanning over 35 years. He leaves behind a wife, many family members, and close friends who will miss his vibrant personality, constant jokes, and frequent banter." Markie had previously been hospitalized in the summer of 2020 due to health issues related to his type 2 diabetes. Man. A source told publication that Markie had died at 6:25 p.m. with his wife, Tara Hall, holding his hand through his final moments as the nursing staff supported the family. The rapper and his family remained tight-lipped about his medical condition throughout the past year. And in 2020, TMZ reported that Markie had been hospitalized for weeks due to his diabetes. In April, Big Daddy Kane claimed during an appearance on The Breakfast Club that Biz Markie was undergoing physical rehab and had been making improvements. You know, so, you know, what was that all about? You know, maybe he just, that was maybe his prayer for his brother. Friends and those influenced by the late rapper took to social media later on Friday to pay tribute to him and share their sorrow. Chance the Rapper tweeted in a video of Markie beat boxing in a hilarious Men in Black 2 scene while simply captioning with the sad-eyed emoji and flying dove. Jay Spence the King shared the same clip and wrote, "R.I.P. to a legend." Kerry Washington remembered being in awe when she would get to see the rapper DJing a set. "When I was a teenager, we used to sneak out on Monday night to hit the hottest parties in New York City," she began. "Soul Kitchen taught us how to let the music live in my body. Whenever we saw Biz on the ones and twos, we were in awe. He was a genius. Rest in peace and soul at Biz Markie." Flea, the bassist for Red Hot Chili Peppers, said he will be listening to Markie's music to the day I die. "All of my love to the kind of a bringer of love and joy, the great Biz Markie. I will bang his records until the day I die, and my heart will rejoice. I love you, Biz." Legendary rapper and producer Q-Tip also paid tribute to his contemporary. "This one hurts. It hurts real bad. Rest in peace to my Aries bro. Oh, man, at Biz Markie. Damn, I'm going to miss you. So many memories," he wrote. "This hurts bad, my friend." Shout out to y'all, my fellow Aryan brothers. Boosie Collins, we lost another rap legend, Mr. Biz Markie, an American rapper, singer, DJ, record producer, actor, comedian, writer. He's best known for his 89 single, Just a Friend. To a lot of us, he was more than just a friend. So R.I.P. and prayers is going out to the family and to the friends. Boosie. Chris Hayes. Oh, this is so sad. R.I.P. Biz. Evelyn Lozada. R.I.P. Biz, a true legend. I mean, everybody in Brooklyn, I mean, and he's just a legend. Just a legend. Tamron Hall, rest in peace. This man made me laugh, cry, feel such joy. You will be missed. The incomparable Biz Markie, not just a friend, an inspirational soul. Wow. It's interesting. Damn. He was a love. Rest in peace. That's from Holly Robinson Pete. Miles Brown. Rest in peace at Biz Markie. Thank you for the inspiration. This is wild. And they got a picture of rapper and actor and rapper Miles Brown, just a child when he got his photo taken with Biz Markie. Markie. Rest in peace in Beats, brother. That was from Public Enemy. Wow. Another legend. That diabetes. Ain't no joke. He was a classic from the classic rap beginning days. Not this stuff they play today. You know, he was an authentic old school rapper. And that's why you see a lot of people remember him from that. Markie had his greatest success in 1989 with the release of Just a Friend, which featured a prominent melody interpolated from Freddie Scott's You Got What I Need. The piano melody gave the song a pop music feel and that departed from other popular hip-hop songs in the era. And Markie's rag vocals added a charming, lighthearted touch to the tune. The song peaked in the top 10 in the Billboard Top 100. And its humorous video, which included a section of him dressed as Mozart in a powder wig at the piano, helped it become a lasting track. Markie was among several rappers who were hit by lawsuits, though, in the early 90s for using samples in their songs without permission. And throughout the 80s, many artists created hip-hop and rap songs that were filled with dense layers of samples, in contrast to contemporary rap songs where most artists use just a few samples that had been approved and paid for. No, not like back in the day. After releasing his third album, 1991's I Need a Haircut, Markie was sued by singer-songwriter Gilbert O'Sullivan for sampling his song, Alone Again, Naturally, on Markie's track, Alone Again. A judge hearing that case ruled in favor of O'Sullivan and escalated the lawsuit by referring to it in criminal court. Damn. No charges were ever brought against Markie or others involved in creating the song, though it would affect his musical career going forward. That same year, hip-hop group De La Soul was also sued for using uncleared samples by members of the Turtles, effectively ending an era of rampant sampling. Markie managed to laugh about the setback 2 years ago when he released his a fourth album titled All Things Sampled Cleared. Markie was born in Harlem. Okay, I'm sorry. Uptown. As Marcel Theo Hall on April 8th, 1964, though he was raised on Long Island. The musician got his start playing at small clubs around New York in the early 80s before building his cult following with concerts throughout the Northeast. One of the most influential tracks was made the music with your mouth. B.I.Z and a track on the 1988 debut album Going Off. The song showcased his human beatbox skills along with his rapping skills, and Markie will continue to beatbox on other artists' songs and on their features. Following his sampling controversy, the rapper's career entered a fall low period in which he mostly made guest appearances and turned to modest film and TV roles until returning with his final studio album in 2003, Weekend Warrior. He would go on to make multiple appearances with the Beastie Boys, who were open about their admiration of him. Markie appeared on sketch comedy series In Living Color in 1994 and was an announcer in the Comedy Central series Crank Yathers, in which real prank phone calls made by actors and comedians were acted out by puppets. He is most recognizable from the film role that was probably 2002's Men in Black 2, in which he played an alien who was being communicated in a large... I'm sorry. He played an alien being who communicated in a language that sounded exactly like his beatboxing. Markie will be featured as a voice actor in animated shows, including SpongeBob, SquarePants, and Adventure Time. He had a cameo appearances on Fox's Empire and ABC's Blackish. Rest in power, brother. Rest in power. There's Markie. Just a friend. 57 years old. Gone too soon. See you in the next video. Y'all, leave your comments below. Tell me what you think.